frozen music discovers the high notes of architecture around the globe. On a sandy island by a coral reef sits a phenomenal holiday destination, where shell-like wooden villas stand on stilts above turquoise waters and beautiful beach houses blend in with the surrounding dunes. Let's visit St. Regis Red Sea Resort on Ummahat Island, Saudi Arabia. This paradise pairs sophisticated design and modern technology with a remote, off-the-grid setting and a wondrous atmosphere that washes over you the second you arrive. The development is part of the Red Sea Project, one of Saudi Arabia's ambitious giga projects along with NEOM. With many new high-end hotels and resorts, the coastline and nearby islands are turning into a world-class tourist area. Behind this vision is a huge amount of architectural precision. In the St. Regis Red Sea, every detail is meticulously planned with the highest standards of craftsmanship and sustainability. The developer, Red Sea Global, brought in the Japanese practice Kengo, Kuma and Associates. Famous for cultural landmarks like Scotland's V&A Dundee, the Hans Christian Andersen Museum in Copenhagen, Denmark, and the Exchange Centre in Sydney, Australia. This was Kengo Kuma's first time working in Saudi Arabia. Nicola Maniero, who led the project team, said they were fascinated by the challenge. New country, new climate, new lifestyle, and a site that is anything but average. Once the design had taken shape, the solution was driven by the choice of material, which takes us to another part of the world, as European spruce wood is the main material for every structure here. Timber elements were prefabricated and treated in Switzerland by Blumer Lehmann, then shipped across the sea. This allowed the architects to drastically reduce the amount of concrete poured. This location has committed to regenerative tourism, which means not just being neutral, but actively improving the ecosystem around it. Here, it starts with the island itself, which was at risk from rising sea levels and tidal erosion. Within years, it could have disappeared, and with it, the nesting grounds of turtles and birds and a huge mangrove forest. With the sand infill, the island terrain was lifted further above sea level, safeguarding its integrity and biodiversity. The villas are also elevated. There are 47 on the beach and 43 directly over the water. You might think their position on the west of the island is just for a stunning sunset view, but it's also to reduce the impact on the east side's coral reef. Responsibility for nature is central to this resort's ethos. It also runs entirely on renewable energy. PV panels are paired with an enormous mainland battery storage facility. For energy distribution, the developer turned to another global provider from Switzerland, ABB, who provided System Pro e-power switchgear and mini center boards plus an asset management solution. Every element was designed to meet the unique challenges of an offshore site, delivering reliability, visibility and peace of mind. What will you remember from a visit to the St. Regis Red Sea Resort? Beyond its breathtaking beauty and magic, the exquisite luxury and the comfort you experience in the villas, restaurants and spa. It's the feeling that you've lived in harmony with your surroundings, taking nothing away from nature, leaving no waste behind. Nicola hopes the project will make us view architecture and the environment as two parts of the same whole, one completing the other. What a sublime statement. Thank you for watching. To catch every episode, just subscribe to our newsletter. I'm Katrin Förster, and I hope to see you next time. Stay safe.